I'm Chrisferb and I'm going to review how to perform an exponential probability distribution calculation on the TI83 and the TI84 variant calculator. There's a lot of different variants of these, but we have some common types of the 83 and 84 that we're going to use. So I'm using Wabbit MU as the emulator, and it's very common. Very common emulator for these. Okay, we'll get started with the TI83. This is a very, very basic 83 version, and they still work just fine. We do second, so we push this yellow key. It's usually yellow. Some of these are different color key combinations nowadays. And then we go down and we find the LN, and you'll see that because we hit the second, it's the second capability of the key. You'll see the little E with the X. And so this will give us our constant value that we're looking for. And so we're going to hit enter on the LN. And so what this does is it gives us the caret. And so the caret's usually used when you have, you want to have an exponent, and it's not necessarily two. Some of these will do, some of the calculators, they'll have this key kind of like we already have here, where it's an X and then the 2, so it's just a basic squaring. With the caret, it allows you to put in whatever value you want in the exponent position. So in this case, I'm going to put in, so take a look. We have an open parentheses, and we have to put a closed one when we're done. But the other thing that I want to point out is our negative symbol. So this is our negative symbol right here. Don't confuse it with the subtraction symbol, because you'll get an error. They're different in this case. A lot of times in algebra, it doesn't make a difference. In this case, it does. And so put in your negative. And then we're going to just do a basic little calculation here. 1 with a division symbol, so it's going to be 1 over 2 as a fraction. And then I need to do a close parentheses in this case. And then I'm going to hit enter. And so we have an answer right there. Okay, so like I said, really basic. I'm not getting into all of the details of the exponential probability distribution. I'm just trying to show you how to do the calculation. And so this takes care of everything with the actual value of that E, of that constant value. It takes care of it. Technically, it's more accurate than typing in a long version of that constant, because it technically it goes out further than what you would be able to type in. Okay, let's take a look at the TI-84. So with the TI-84, we hit the second. On this one, it's a blue key. That's just the way the color scheme is. And then, same thing, we're going to hit this LN, but because we hit second first, it's going to pull up that E, the E constant with the exponent right there. And so now what we're going to do, we don't need to put in any parentheses. If you have any complicated calculations, parentheses are usually good, but in this case it's not going to be. We have to put in our negative. Remember, this is the negative, not a subtraction symbol. And then we're going to just do 1 over 2, so it's essentially half a fraction. And then I usually go, when I'm in this exponent type of mode, I usually go and hit the right arrow key to pull it out of that mode. You don't need to necessarily, but if you're doing any other multiplication, you should get out of this mode before you do more of it, because otherwise you're going to be in this exponent mode, which makes it so that the other numbers that you type in right after this 2 are still in the exponent in the superscript level of text. So you need to get out of that, but in our case it wouldn't matter. I'm just going to hit enter. And there we go. There's our answer. Now, both of these, of course, work fine. Just remember, if you're using the TI-83 or one of the older version calculators, to put that closed exponent's really important. And other than that, they will both work just fine for you. But remember, whenever you see the open parentheses, you need to have a closed parentheses. And that would be it. Thanks.